have received so many comments concerning energy changes in capacitors, and I came across this question that I want us to solve together. The question reads that the figure below shows a circuit diagram of two capacitors connected to a 10 volt supply. C1, that is capacitor 1, was fully charged by connecting to a terminal A. The switch was then disconnected to terminal B to charge capacitor C2. If C1 and C2 has a capacitance of 3 microfarads and 1 microfarad respectively, calculate A, initial energy in C1. So in this case, you want to get the initial energy in C1 before we charge it. So we know that energy is given by work done, which is equal to a half multiplied by capacitance multiplied by voltage. That is the charging voltage squared. So energy is given by a half. The capacitance of C1, we are told that C1 is 3 microfarad, that is 10 times negative 6, multiplied by V. In this case, V is 10, so 10 squared. So by 2, 1, by 2, 5, so we end up having that is 5.0 times 10. Now, supposed to be 50 multiplied by 3, that is 150. So 1.5 times 10 to power 5. To power 4 joules. So that is for part A. Part B, we are told to calculate the initial charge. Part B, initial charge in C1. Now, to obtain the charge, we know that charge is given by charge is equal to CV. So we get the capacitance of C1, that is 3 times 10 to the power negative 6 multiplied by 10, whereby this V is the charging voltage multiplied by 10, which gives us 3 times 0.10 power 5 coulombs. That is part B. Part C, we are asked to calculate the effective capacitance of the circuit. Remember, the two capacitors are in series. So for us to get the capacitors effective for capacitors connected in parallel, we take C1 plus C2. So we have 1 plus 3, which is 4 times 10 power negative 6 farads. Part D, we are told to calculate the potential difference across C1 and C2. We know that charge is equal to CV. Now, in this case, we know that when capacitors are connected in parallel, we have the same charge. So the charge that we had obtained in B, we will use it here. Then, this capacitance here, now this we use the effective capacitance that we have obtained in C, and then we want to obtain the voltage across the two capacitors. So we have Q as 3.0 times 10 to power negative 5 coulombs, and C effective is 4.0 times 10 to power negative 6 farads. So we have replacing in our equation 3.0 times 10 to power negative 5 coulombs equals to 4.0 times 10 power negative 6 times V. So we divide both sides by 4.0 times 10 power negative 6 divided by 4.0 times 10 power negative 6. So this and this goes, and we are remained with V. So when we take this one up there, we end up having 3 over 4 times 10, that is times 10, which is basically 30 over 4 is equals to V. This is 7.5 volts, and that is the voltage across the two capacitors. Then lastly, we are asked to calculate the total energy, that is part E. We are asked to calculate the total energy in the system. So for us to get total energy, we say that energy is given by half C V squared. Now in this case, we have a half multiplied by this. Our C here is C effective, the effective capacitance. We will obtain it in part C, which is 4.0 times 10 to power negative 6, multiplied by V. We have obtained V as 7.5 times 7.5 voltage. So from there, now we can have by 2 1 by 2 2, so we have 15 times 10 power negative 6 joules, and that is our solution.